Today's lecture is on Kirchhoff's other circuit law. In addition to his KCL law, he has a voltage law, KVL, and this law is based on the conservation of energy. Remember from your physics that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. And you see, it should make sense to you based on previous discussion that this voltage law would be based on conservation of energy, because after all, voltage is an indication of the amount of energy it takes to get charge to move between two nodes in a circuit. So remember, a volt is equal to a joule per coulomb, so it's not exactly equal to energy, but it depends on energy. So there's several different ways to look at this law. Here's one statement, that around a loop, voltage rises equals voltage drops. Well, first of all, a loop is just a closed path. So a loop is just another word for closed path. So around a closed path, voltage rises equals voltage drops. And this is what a voltage rise is. It's when current exits the higher voltage end of an element. So if you have current flowing from the lower voltage end to the higher voltage end, that's considered a voltage rise. And then if you have the opposite, where current exits the lower voltage end, so it's entering the higher voltage end and exiting the lower voltage end, well, that's a voltage drop. Okay, so that's one way to state Kirchhoff's voltage law. Another way is to simply say around a loop, your minus to plus voltages equal your plus to minus voltages. Because maybe sometimes in problems you won't know the current direction to start off with, so you won't know what's a rise and what's a drop necessarily at the beginning of a problem. Depends on the problem. And then a third way is this word algebraic sum. Around a loop, the algebraic sum of voltages sum to zero. So again, this is where you need to assign a plus and a negative sign to whether you have a minus to plus voltage or plus to minus voltage. Now, what I have here is actually based on a different book than what we're using this quarter. The Alexander book that we're using this quarter actually assigns a negative sign to minus to plus voltages and a plus sign to plus to minus voltages. So the text is actually opposite this, but that just proves the point that, you know, as long as you have opposite signs for these two cases, you know, mathematically it's going to be the sum. But just be aware that when you look in the book, it's actually going to be opposite of what I have here on the slide. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple of problems that involve KVL. So here we have just, you know, these blob shapes here just represent, you know, something in a circuit. And you can see that there's voltages along with the polarities defined for each of those items that we have. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go around this closed path. We're going to go around this loop in a clockwise fashion. Now, we could just as very easily go around counterclockwise, and we're still going to get the same answer. Okay, so it doesn't matter which direction you go, clockwise or counterclockwise, you just go the same direction through the entire loop as you're doing the KVL. So we're just going to put plus to minus voltages on one side of the equal sign and minus to plus voltages on the other side of the equal sign as we go around the loop. Now, one thing to notice here is this voltage here is a negative voltage, okay, minus 13 volts. So before we start this, I like to you know, first see if there's any negative voltages in the problem, and if there are, I just turn that negative voltage to a positive voltage by switching the polarity. Because remember, one meaning of a negative voltage that we've talked about is that when there's a negative in front of a voltage value, it just means the polarity being shown is really opposite. So you see, I can make this a plus, and then I'll just make this the higher voltage end and this the lower voltage end. Okay, so now I'm going to go around the loop clockwise, and as I do, this is a minus the plus voltage, so that's going to go on this side of the equal sign. Okay, that 5 volts goes here. Okay, then As I continue on, I get up to where the 6 volts is. So going clockwise, I'm going plus to minus, okay, plus to minus. So the 6 goes over here. The VX would also go on this sign. Okay, the 4 volts. Right, because again I'm going clockwise, so plus to minus. And then when I get here to the 13 volts, well now as I go clockwise I'm going minus to plus, so the 13 would go on this side. Okay, and then if you go ahead and solve, you can see that VX would just come out to, let's see, what would it be? It'd be 8 volts. Right, just 18 minus 10, so 8 volts. Okay, all right, let's look at a second problem here. Okay, this problem, we've got 2 voltage sources and we have a 10 ohm resistor, and you can see that the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor is defined as Vx. And we're told the direction of the current. Direction of the current, as you can see, is clockwise, this Ix. So since we know the direction of the current in this problem, we could set up the KVL where we have voltage rises on one side of the equal sign. Okay, so voltage rises, I'll just put VR, equal voltage drops. Okay, so this time we're going to go in the direction of the current flow. Okay, since the direction of the current flow has a lot to do with whether we have a rise or drop. So right here at the 12 volt source, going in the direction of Ix, I'm going minus the plus in voltage. So you see that's a rise, because as the current flows through the source, it's going from the lower end to the higher voltage end. So that 12 would go on this side. Okay. Then still going in the direction of Ix. Now as the Ix current goes through the 7 volt source, it's going plus to minus, so that's a drop. Okay, and then we get to the resistor. Now, you always have a voltage drop across a resistor, and you can see it here that Ix enters the higher voltage end, so it's going plus to minus. But remember, resistors can only absorb power, so you're always going to have a voltage drop across a resistor, so Vx would be over here. Okay, and if you go ahead and solve, you can see Vx equals 5 volts. And we would get the same answer if we didn't do rises equals drops, but we did algebraic sum of the voltages equal to 0. I mean, just real quick, let's see that we get the same answer. So now I'm just going to go clockwise around the loop, and I'll use the book way of doing the sign. So the book way is as I go around the loop and I get to this 12 volt source, I'm going minus the plus in voltage. So the book author will assign a minus sign to that voltage, so minus 12. Okay. Then when we get to the 7 volt source, going clockwise, we're going to go plus to minus in voltage. Okay, going clockwise, we're going to go plus to minus in voltage. So the author assigns that a plus. Okay, and likewise, Vx would be plus, and then see that sums to 0. So right, take the Vx to the other side, minus Vx, so minus Vx equals minus 5, Vx equals 5, you get the same answer. Now, we could, you know, that was KVL, but if we wanted to find the current Ix here, we could by just doing Ohm's law. Since we know there's 5 volts across this 10 ohm resistor, Ohm's law, current is voltage divided by resistance. So you see Ix would just be the 5 volts across the resistor divided by 10 ohms. So half an amp. So you see there's half a amp flowing through that 10 ohm resistor, and there's also half an amp flowing throughout this entire single path, because see, again, here's a series circuit. We first mentioned that last lecture, that when you have a single path for current to flow, that's called a series circuit, and all elements in series have the same current. So not only does that 10 ohm resistor have half an amp, but the 12 volt source has half an amp, and also the 7 volt source has half an amp. Now, before we end this lecture, let's go back to a problem from the last video. This problem here, you may recall that we found that there was 9 volts across both this resistor RA and also across this resistor, the 6 ohm resistor. And the way we reasoned that there was 9 volts across RA and the 6 ohms as well as this 9 volt source was that there's shorts that are connecting between those elements, and that there's 0 volts across a short. Well, another way to reason that both RA and the 6 ohm have 6 volts across them is just to do KVL around each of these loops. See, there's a loop here containing the 9 volt source and the 6 ohm, and there's a loop here containing the 9 volt source and RA. So if we put the polarities here, right, the current for RA is entering the top, so that's the higher voltage end, and likewise for the 6 volt. Well, now look, if you do a KVL, you're going to get that 9 volts equals the voltage across RA, and also you're going to get 9 volts equals the voltage across the 6 ohm. So you see, that's another way to show that when you have a connection like this, which by the way is called parallel, the voltage is the same. Okay, so you know, as I mentioned previously, when you have elements in series, current's the same. When you have elements connected, as you see here, that share the same two nodes, well, that's called parallel, and that's when you have constant voltage. You have the same voltage across parallel elements. And again, we're going to talk a whole lot more about series and parallel circuits coming up in a future lecture, but I just wanted to come back and point that out in that problem we did previously. And then the very last thing is just a summary. See, there are three very important conservation principles in circuits, and we've now covered all three of these, and we're going to be using these the rest of the quarter in any circuits class you take. You're going to be using these. These are super important to have ingrained. You know, you really have to have these ingrained in your soul if you're an EE or CPE. You know, first, power is conserved in a circuit, right? In a circuit, the amount of power being supplied equals the amount of power being absorbed. Current's conserved, and specifically, it's conserved at a node, at a connection point, that, you know, the current flowing into a node equals the current flowing out of that node. Right, conservation of charge is the basis behind that, like we discussed. So that's KCL. And then this lecture, voltage is conserved around a loop. Okay, around a closed path, your voltages are going to sum to zero. Your plus to minus voltages are going to equal your minus to plus voltages. And that's based on the conservation of energy, like we discussed. And that's KVL. So know these. Know them like your best friend.